And here we go. Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Samrak.
I'm Lena.
I'm Zara.
We are on the season finale of The Bear, episode 8 of season 1. Braciole?
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 Braciole? Who knows?
Italian? Probably butchering it. It's an Italian word, yeah? Mm-hmm. Yeah, but we're coming off what I believe was the best episode of the season so far.
Chef's kiss, as they say.
Yeah.
Just the way that it was shot, one shot. The chaos, everything that was going on.
Pandemonium.
Yeah.
Tina was surprisingly the calmest one out of the group.
She was kind.
Yeah, and then everybody else just like, dude, well, people quitting. Yeah. Marcus seemed like he's on the verge of quitting the way he tossed everything down like that. And then Sydney surprised me when she, you know, out of all people. And she done stabbed somebody and then.
Richie.
Yeah, so
it was intense. Yeah.
Yeah, we're excited to see what this finale has in store. Cause like I stated, usually they don't pick up where they left off, but we want to know like what happened that day. You know, I mean, I'm sure they're gonna go back, but I kind of want to see what happened right then and there.
We'll see.
Yeah, but they haven't done that yet so far. Yeah, so we're ready.
Yeah, we are.
Yep. So The Bear season 1 episode 8. I'm not gonna butcher the word anymore. So if you do like our reaction, please like, comment, subscribe, so hit the notification bell. All right, let's do this. And here we go.
Oh, yes.
What?
The bear.
Zotto, and today we're going to be making beef braciole.
Braciole.
Nightmare of a household. My brother Mike made this for us every single Sunday.
And you got- Is it a dream?
Gotta be.
Except he did leave me our family's restaurant in his will, which was a nice curve.
Oh, there is a letter.
Work there with him, even though I'm pretty good at this, right? Anyway, Braciole.
Braciole, that's it.
Braciole?
Yeah.
Oh, the meat's gone. Oh, it's gone.
What? That's gotta be a dream.
It was the dish he was rolling the meat in with Michael.
Mm. What's going on?
Right, what is going on?
Shit! Mike!
It's crossover with everything.
I'm sorry, I'm just fucking this up, guys. Fucking this up, stop, please.
The bear, the opening scene. Oh. Teleprompter with the bear.
I'm right here.
Cicero. Oh, Uncle Jimmy.
Hey, Carl. Can you hear me?
Fuck off, my Xbox!
Oh, they're gonna.
Fuck off!
Are they gonna summarize everything? All the scenes?
Hey, bear. Let it rip.
Is that Michael?
Oh, his narration is Michael. Okay.
Fewer than 15 meetings like to speak.
He's gonna go off.
So we'll see.
Some of his brothers, like the incident, more in detail.
Food was always our common ground. We wanted to open a restaurant together. He would always say, stupid. He would always say, let it rip.
Let it rip.
He was loud. And he was hilarious.
Always the loudest in a room, right?
And he had this amazing ability. He could walk into a room and he could take the temperature of it instantly. Like I was good at something that was so new and that was so exciting, and I just wanted him to know that, and fuck, I just wanted him to be like, good job.
But never got it, huh?
Yeah.
And the more our relationship kind of strained, the deeper into this I went and the better I got.
Is that the reason why?
I guess so.
Anything from Marcus yet?
No, Jeff.
Real. She just missed my aunt. Fuck.
I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but we are going to be closed for dinner service tonight because we are having a bachelor party in the front.
Fuck that.
It's Cicero's friends, so.
Yeah. Oh, cousin.
Sucks, Jeff. I was just getting into the zone.
No, I know. I get it.
I'll run point out front tonight in case I got to use the big boy voice.
I think we'll be fine. Thank you.
Well, you can never tell with these white-collar criminals.
Come, how many people?
How many people? I'm not sure, but we're going to try to keep it chill. They're going to bring their own booze. We're going to have snacks. Small.
Carmi's an asshole.
Okay, I see
you. You see me?
Whoa.
Find an ingredients.
What's going on here?
The compliments. Jeez. Now I see you and salt. And
You're out of control.
Yeah.
How you're doing with everything since
the day.
Yeah. I mean, I feel okay. Better. You know, my head just got real fucked up for a minute.
I mean, welcome to the club.
Is that not?
Did he quit as well?
It would be weird to work in a restaurant and not completely lose your mind.
Mm. Yeah. Mm. Mm. It's good.
I mean, about to find out.
So what is this?
This is a Chilean sea bass. We got a little Alain Bassard inspired tomato confit. Oh man, when I was at the CIA, the Culinary Institute of America.
Yeah, thanks CIA. For clearing that up. Yeah, I thought you were a spy.
Wait 1 second, because I forgot.
Ooh, lemon.
Get ready for this.
A little bit of zest.
I had a chef who would only let me zest. That was it. It's for like 8 months, and all I did was zest.
Oh, that's normal.
So normal.
Yeah.
She should be pretty good at zesting.
You good?
Yeah.
Is she not a voice of reason?
You're not as annoying as usual.
Tired, I think.
Heard.
You're dressed like Sid.
Oh, yeah. She's in the uniform, the blue apron.
Oh, yeah. Yay. She usually has a other apron.
Hey, T, you don't know anything about KBL Electric. Do you? Mikey never mentioned anything about that to you.
Who the fuck knows? That kid? I don't want to know. What's it for?
I don't know.
It's in the books.
These big pieces out every month.
That's a lot.
Just roll on them.
How much was the loan?
$2,000 off. Sure, he won't.
A lot of bachelor parties to pay it back. You know how much I loved him, right? I loved him a lot. Thanks, Chip.
I had some of your donut the other day.
Off the floor? I don't want to hear it. That's not a good excuse.
And I'm really sorry that Carmi destroyed it like a little bitch.
That's exactly what he did. He destroyed it like a bitch.
Little bitch.
A little small bitch. Like, for my cousin Terrell's graduation, we went to Michael Jordan's Steakhouse.
Okay, and?
I mean, and it's the best restaurant. Yes, exactly. You understand. Yeah. It's the best bacon. What was the best one?
Best what?
Best meal you ever had.
I thought.
It was Carnegie's.
I knew it.
Yeah.
High praise.
Yeah, but he's still a little bitch.
I don't disagree.
Meanwhile, Richie?
Is it Richie?
It's gotta be.
Oh, the bachelor party. Okay, wow. I thought about the club. Forgot all about it.
This is a fucking disgrace right here.
Wow. guy who runs a sandwich shop as a bachelor party.
Yeah.
Never thought he was would.
Yeah, you don't see that coming.
He's so loud and obnoxious and fucking.
Life of the party.
He's Mikey Bear. I thought.
Oh, he's.
He would pull out of it.
Mikey Bear and Carmy Bear.
It's a nickname.
Yeah.
Oh.
Be fucking kidding.
Here we go.
Of course.
Hey, get the fuck.
Enough.
Enough.
Oh, God.
Ooh, swinging at him. Oh.
Ooh.
Is that Cicero? Don't tell me that's Cicero.
No. Oh, God.
Oh. Oh, welcome back, Richie.
Any word?
Nothing yet.
Oh.
Who's he gonna call? Carmy?
Pete?
He's not
gonna call Carmy. He's gonna call Pete.
Hey, this is Tiff. Leave a message after the tone.
Tiff.
Oh, baby mama. Baby mama.
Okay. Sorry. I know it's late. I just, you know.
I was supposed to pick up his daughter.
Bad news.
I'm sorry.
It's like his goodbye.
That's pretty much it. Hope you guys had a good day. Give Ava a big hug. Yeah, I'll talk to you later. Okay, good night.
Aww.
It's like his farewell?
Yeah.
He's just preparing for the worst scenario. Yeah? Mm-hmm. Good news?
Jeremovich, let's go.
Woo!
You woke up?
You got lucky.
Thank God.
He's breaking up a fight.
Where'd you get the money for bail?
Mm-hmm. Mm. Cicero?
Used our 2-week parachute. Thank you, cousin. Okay. Get ball breaker ready, yeah?
Oh, come back up the Norwegian Mortal Kombat.
Okay.
Man, his life could have been over.
Yeah.
Just a moment.
You're all I got, cuz.
Right? Yeah?
Mess. Oh man, I gotta clean up. Ball break. Oh God.
Oh, he's back.
He's back, yay. Here we go.
Is he accepted? Let's see.
Oh.
Got him in.
Oh. Oh, okay. I thought he was going to like, why are you here, bro?
I thought he was going to apologize.
I'm so sorry, Chef.
Oh.
Happy you're back. Yes, Chef.
Carmen.
Yep.
What the fuck is this?
My station.
Chef, that is not respect.
That way.
Hey.
Sweet.
Oh, bendito, my little felon.
My little felon.
You hooligan.
A souvenir for your troubles.
Yeah.
Oh, she's cleaning it good.
Wait, is he gonna stumble upon the letter?
Oh yeah, the letter.
Talk about it.
What?
Beat the shit out of people.
I get it.
So I want the front of house locked and loaded, please. All right?
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
He's got sharpies.
Sharpies.
Oh, that's Marcus, right?
Or?
Oh, okay, Sydney's recipes.
It's her book.
I feel like they all have their own recipe books, right? Booklet.
Yeah.
Great, yeah, thank you. Hold up, no, this is, that's pork, I don't need pork.
I'm just the delivery guy. Take it over, Lou.
What?
Why do they always get the meat wrong? Oh, he's gonna make the ribs. Her ribs. It's pork, right? He has the recipe.
It's all there. He's like, fuck it. Let's do this. That's the only card he has, right? To play with.
That was her point, too. It was like, things that we already have. That was her thing. Whoa. What?
Is that having one of his attack? Yeah.
It's like a stream. And everything caught on fire.
Everybody's like, cousin, cousin, chef. Always a bear growl, yeah?
Yo, hey, yo, fuck.
He was talking about that situation before, right?
Then he'd all burn. Yeah. All his palms would be on.
Right there. This whole time. Gonna give him the reason why he said he didn't leave a note. He didn't leave nothing.
We need to know.
We need his closure. Some his karmic success that drove him to that. But that was tough love, in a sense. They both need the closure.
Yeah.
Because he realized he's all he's got. Remember, he said, "You're all I got, cousin."
Yeah.
Family.
Is he gonna read it?
Read it.
No acid. No. Oh, all the ingredients, right? The recipe. Well, that's why he said to her, it's not perfect yet. Oh, pick up your last paycheck.
He's honest, he's accepting. He didn't want to make the spaghetti.
Yeah. From the first episode, tossing it away, right?
What?
Can he make it?
No. In Somalia, I am grill master.
You old bitch.
Sexist.
I got you. I'm gonna fix this.
Oh, you got me?
I got you.
How about this? How about we got you? We're giving you an opportunity to work here. Even prove yourself. Maybe put some money in your pocket.
Yeah. What did he ever do wrong? It's like, why are they so hard on him?
Looked pretty cool.
Scars.
Just got stabbed and he like walked it off and it was kind of, it's pretty tough.
Yeah.
Money?
Oh.
Oh. Oh. That's why he said the smaller ones.
Cousin!
Yo!
Help!
Everybody! Oh, yeah, all hands! All hands!
Oh, shit. Oh, wow. They're full of tomato. Oh, God.
What's,
Jeff.
Sid, quit fucking around. Grab a can opener.
Oh, God.
Family style?
Family style.
Okay.
Aww. Wow, if he had just made spaghetti that first day.
Oh, yeah. So KBL, KBL, KBL. Okay.
Oh.
What?
What?
The bear.
Ooh.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay. Wow.
Wow.
Spaghetti. Aww. Scary, scary.
Aww. Wow, that was
sugar.
Sugar.
Pete.
Even Pete.
Okay, it's the season finale, so they're bringing everybody, huh? Yeah.
Oh, I like that.
Oh. Oh, don't do this.
And that was The Bear, Season 1, Episode 8, the season finale.
Yay.
So, KBL, like Stash.
Surprise!
I don't quite, so, they were in depth, but we don't know yet, right? What?
Yeah, I'm sure we're gonna figure out.
Where the money is, why the money is there.
Mm-hmm.
And then,
yeah.
I was trying to figure it out as we were watching it with the, mm-hmm. what was going, why is there, I know the, KBL, because he saw at the bottom of the can, KBL, KBL, mm-hmm. and he was asking Tina.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, what's this KBL?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She didn't know.
Yeah, she didn't know. And then so, it's, well, it's had to be something that caused him to take his own self out, right?
Yeah.
You know, KBL. And then he, oh, Cicero has a amount of money, but it has another, like, pile. Mm. They didn't say how much it was, right?
No.
No?
No,
it's got to be a
lot.
It looked a lot, yeah.
Because it was a whole three shelves.
There was racks on racks on racks on racks, yeah.
Isn't it funny how in the first episode they almost had him make it? And he would have discovered it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But and he didn't do it.
Yeah.
He even threw one in the trash.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Somebody found a stash.
Hopefully there wasn't a lot in there. But
yeah, he opened it like halfway, right?
Mm-hmm. Threw it.
But that's what we needed. We need that story arc with all the characters.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
And now they're almost complete story-wise.
Yeah, so they
and
went
now
through.
Now they're starting the bear.
Yeah, so that's what it is.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And what he was describing to Sydney was a vision of a restaurant.
Yeah.
Like the description of what type of tables they wanted.
Yeah.
What the outlook was, a Danish look. So.
Oh, so how exciting.
His brother's given him the opportunity to do.
Yeah.
Okay.
The song restaurant.
Yeah, that's what he was saying to her. He was saying, and then there's like a side window for takeout sandwiches.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay, but the narration, right? Oh, that scene right there.
It seemed a little confusing, but he was describing like, their vision of a restaurant.
Yeah.
Okay, prior to that scene right there.
When she was
she was coming in.
Yeah, but she didn't say anything. Just like the narration, right?
She saw the money. Mm-hmm. She's like, what's going on?
Yeah. Oh, it flashed back to what he was talking about, right?
No, that was that moment.
He's like, explaining to her, like, you know, this is all the money we have, this is what we're gonna do, like, please come back, you know.
Wait, just like get her on board.
Why did I overlook this?
I don't know.
Wait, what?
You know, she was like,
when she walked in, right? He didn't move his mouth, right? He was just
He was talking to her.
He was talking to her.
He was like describing.
Oh, okay. I thought he was like, okay, I guess I didn't zone out, but I thought he was like, because everything was going on, I didn't know that he was speaking. I just thought it was a narration.
You were seeing all the money?
Yeah.
I guess I was focused. Richie was like, oh.
Yeah.
Okay. Dude, I guess I overlooked that one.
And that's why they said the bear beef is closed. Mm. The bear is coming. Mm. And then that's why she asked him, do you have a name for it? And
yeah.
Okay, what the heck? I guess, you know what it was, why I overlooked it? I was trying to figure out what the money was for. Like, why is there money? Like, why is... Cause I was just trying to process it at the time. Like, okay, he's in debt with Cicero, owing this much money, but then now he's showing... I was going to say Philip. He's showing Carmi... like, you know, money to like open up this restaurant. Mm. I didn't see that part. I was like trying to figure out like what is the whole. We'll I guess see. I was overthinking
we'll see,
it.
Yeah.
I was season overthinking two? It. Yeah.
Season two.
Can't wow. wait.
But isn't that wild? Like I was like I didn't even realize the money was stashed in there either.
Yeah.
But, and it was just like. Yeah.
Yeah. Like a KBL that was stash really good. Every yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that'll be interesting season two. It's like a different. It's a whole different thing now because they have money.
Yeah.
It's a new name.
But now, isn't Cicero going to be like, wait, what do you guys have the money to do all this?
We'll see.
Sure, I haven't been paid
they
yet.
They probably have to launder it.
Yeah, the white collar criminal. They're getting anything from it yet. So, how do you get the money to do this?
Yeah.
So, it's going to be a whole new, yeah.
And everyone's on board now.
Yeah. They are.
I mean, I feel like Richie also had a, how do you say, awakening, wake up call.
Yeah.
He
seems like
yeah. After going through what he did,
We
have the funds for all this, so I'm on board basically. Yeah, so that changes everything.
It's like it brightened everyone's mood. It's like a spark.
Yeah.
Okay, but we don't know he got that stash.
Yeah.
So that's what my thing.
Season two.
That's why I overthought everything. I was just trying to think the scenario during that scene.
Yeah.
I thought I didn't know his mouth was moving talking to Sydney. I thought it was just like a narration came over.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
finale.
That was a good finale. Yeah,
very good. Very
good. It was calm for the most part than the bachelor party.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it was for a couple of minutes, then it went calm again when he was in the cell and all that. Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, family dinner right there. So I guess they're because she is part owner of that build or that lease that they signed the name.
Sugar.
So that's why, Sugar. She was there with Pete.
Yeah.
No, no.
Also their family too.
Yeah, their family, but I'm saying this is extended family because usually it's the family of the people that work there. Now it's the special. Actual family, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Special
were you
night.
Worried they weren't going to give him a letter from Mikey?
No, I totally forgot about it.
Yeah, I forgot about it for a while and then I remembered it. And
it's good.
Yeah, I remembered it before he even, when he was sitting there, then like Richie came, like, oh, the letter. So
yeah.
Took it out. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, this is good. Good little plot twist there.
Yay!
Yeah, so The Bear, season 1, episode 8. I'm not going to butcher the name, but that was the season finale. Mm-hmm. So if you do like our reaction, please like, comment, subscribe, also hit the notification bell, and we'll see you next season.
Goodbye.